Hello YouTube, this is BGA. Hope everyone's doing well. It's kind of a cloudy, rainy day here, so I figured I'd do a couple videos. And the first one I want to do is talking to you about some of the grooming products that I use. Primarily shaving, but I'll get into some other things as well. On the topic of shaving, I have a very sensitive skin and a relatively coarse beard, not a great combination. Furthermore, my hair grows in a million different directions. So shaving for me has not always been the most pleasant or comfortable experience. The pattern I was in was I would, the first real razor I remember using was the Gillette Mach 3 when it had first come out. And I would only be able to use it maybe once every 3 days. If I shaved consecutive days, I would get terrible skin irritation, redness, especially my neck, and it wouldn't be a smooth shave either. Furthermore, even just one shave, the blade, the next time I shaved, would just slice up my skin. And I researched technique, etc., didn't apply too much pressure. One thing I'll say that I did do, I cannot stand the feeling of any hair left on my face after I shave. If I miss a spot, some people don't care. The official men's stylist rule of thumb is don't shave against the grain. If I don't shave against the grain all day long, I'm doing this. And if I'm wearing a sweater, let's say, it's going to irritate my neck. So I had to shave against the grain, and I was only happy with when I shaved against the grain. So it would take a while to shave. Could really only shave in the shower without slicing up my face. Always used high quality products, but it took a lot of trial and error. As I got older and more into the professional world, I realized that I had two choices: either grow a beard or figure something out. So I researched shaving for my skin type, and if anybody's just getting into sort of luxury shaving or more comfortable shaving than your drugstore products will provide, the chances are you'll stumble across a company called The Art of Shaving. I'm not going to say anything bad about them, but it's kind of like buying your car cleaning supplies from your car dealership. You're paying a premium for products that aren't necessarily better. For example, this is the Art of Shaving pre-shave oil. Now, if you don't know about pre-shaves or pre-shave oils, this is basically like a olive oil type consistency, maybe slightly thicker. And the idea being you rub it into your skin before you apply your shaving cream, lotion, soap, etc. And it helps the razor glide a little bit smoother, etc. Well, if you shave after the shower, as it's general practice, general recommended practice, the Art of Shaving pre-shave oil, I found even shaving in the shower and washing afterwards leaves like an oily residue. And that's not even using that much. So I really didn't like it. Also, it tends to clog up your razor more, so more rinsing. If you're using a multi-blade razor, Fusion, whatever's out now, it really clogs it up bad. So really not thrilled. Now, I've had this brush for years. This is a shaving brush, and this is also by Art of Shaving. When you get a shaving brush, you want to make sure that you get a badger hair brush. Now, yeah, ideally, you want a silver tip badger, the best hairs on the badger, the most expensive. If you go to classicshaving.com, I believe they still have them. I think one time they were out of stock on all the silver tips. But anyway, this is Art of Shavings. I got this as a gift in like a kit years ago with some of their sandalwood shaving soap. And I see no reason to get a more expensive brush. This is the regular badger hair. So what do you do with this? Well, you get yourself a shaving bowl. Now this I got at the Goodwill store, or the local thrift shop, for probably like $1, $2. Anyway, it's a ceramic bowl, and what you want to do is sit the bowl in the sink, empty, and kind of fill your sink up with as hot of water as you can, so that it's going to heat up the bowl. Then you take your shaving soap, I'm sorry, then you take your shaving brush, leave it in the hot water for a while, let the hair soak up hot water. Then you're gonna kind of shake it out, take your shaving soap, give it a couple swirls, then take your bowl, and you're gonna build up a nice lather. And then when you apply it to your face, don't do circular motions. Do up, down, do straight motions. So anyway, face, neck, etc. As far as shaving soaps go, and hopefully I'm going in an order that makes sense, but anyway, as far as shaving soaps go, there's one for everybody's skin type, scent preference, allergic reactions, etc. And honestly, the unfortunate part is that it's trial and error. So just because I recommend something for me doesn't mean it's going to work for you. But I did not like just the heart. I've tried a couple of the Truth and Hill, which is a high-end shaving slash grooming store based out of company slash stores based out of England. I like some of their products, which I'll get to, but I did not like just their straight soap. I found that it irritated my skin. So overall, just to speed things up a bit, I have found that when wet shaving, so using a traditional razor system, if I use the ProRasso, which is available online, this is their pre-shave lotion for sensitive skin, and it almost has like a menthol-y type of a smell, and it's a cream versus being an oil, and it smells wonderful. And this is their special one designed for sensitive skin, the Crema de Barba Anti-Irrazione. So that's their pre-shave. So you just take a small amount of that. First, obviously, you're going to rinse your face with warm water. Let it let this soak in for a little bit. And unless you're in the shower, and then that's also something. You always want to exfoliate. Use a gentle daily exfoliator on your face before you shave. So when I wet shave, I just do it in the shower. I have a great anti-fog shower mirror. It's the Z Fogless. If you've been looking for one that actually works and stays fogless, it's the Z Fogless. I got mine at one of the flea markets in Palm Beach, Florida. And I have one for my home here, my home there. So I've lost a few while traveling, but anyway, great mirror, has a light, has a clock if that's your thing, and it has a holder if you use like a Mach 3 or a Fusion. But if you are dead set on wet shaving, this is what you want. This is the Mercure Closed Comb Safety Razor. And it uses traditional double-edged blades, which are great for multiple reasons. One, they're really cheap. You can buy the best blades out there, which, well, the best blade depends on your skin type, but when I was shaving with this, what worked the best for me, it's not recommended as a beginner blade because it's so sharp, but it's a Japanese company called Feather, and they come in packs of, I believe, 10. You can usually get them on eBay for like a year's worth for not much money at all. They're individually wrapped, platinum coated, and then it has a little slot that after you use the blade, you can dispose of it in the back of the same container, and then you just throw away the container when you're done. So I believe there's 10, and depending on your beard, they can last quite a while. How you use a DE safety, there's tons of videos on YouTube about this, so and I don't like to duplicate information, but basically you unscrew the bottom here, this little top piece comes off, and here's your double-edged razor. Just slip it on, being extremely careful. I have sliced my finger with this. And that's that. I have tried using a traditional straight razor, cutthroat razor, if you're a James Bond fan, which you probably know I am. In the movie Skyfall, you can see the scene where Daniel Craig is using, I believe it's a Dovo straight razor. I have a Dovo 5/8 Tortoise. Spent a lot of time on the Straight Razor Place forum. It's an art form, and for me, my beard grows in so many different directions, and I require such a smooth shave that it just didn't work. I tried the Dovo. It's called the Chevette. It's a dis where the actual blade is disposable. That was even worse. That one chewed up my skin. Got a great strop, had it professionally honed, and never really got a great shave out of it. Yeah, the experience was interesting, but didn't really notice that it was that. Actually, it was a worse shave. And I know I'll probably get some negative comments for that I was using improper technique. Probably. But I need to shave sideways, and it's really difficult, especially doing it yourself with a long blade, especially around your neck. Never, contrary to popular belief, it's kind of, unless you're like holding the razor at a perpendicular, like at an exact 90-degree angle to your face, and you slide like that. I've never cut myself just terribly. That gashing myth that surrounds straight razors. So yeah, the trick with the DE razors is unfortunately the Mach 3s, the Fusions, whatever's out there now, have allowed us to kind of get lazy and used to pressing down. You do not want to do that with any other shaving method. If you press down, you'll cut yourself, you'll have irritation, etc. Basically, you want to use the weight of the razor. There's someone on YouTube that I used to watch when I was getting into DE shaving, Mantic 59, something like that. So I recommend his videos if you want to learn more about that. still with this, using this method, and I shave the, with this every day for, not every day. I still had irritation, so I could not shave every day, but it was cheaper in the long run with the DE razors versus the Mach 3 Fusion, etc., whatever. So I was using that once every couple days. Got a better shave than I did with the multi-blade razors. The shave lasted longer. Something great, it's one blade, so you can get your sideburns really evenly. And if you know by my other channels, I really like traditional things. So, you know, I write with fountain pens. I kind of like old school things, film cameras, though I do shoot digital. But yeah, I've sort of gotten to a point where, it has to be anything new technology related, you kind of have to prove to me that it's worth upgrading or I won't do it. So that's wet shaving. I went over the brush, shaving bowl. So best that I've found for sensitive skin with a coarse beard is the ProResso. And then here's their shaving soap. It's a little more creamy. I believe they do make straight creams too, if that's your style. The absolute worst, and I love some of their products, Kiehl's, KIEHL'S, I believe is how it's spelled. They have some great men's grooming products, especially one of their intensive hand moisturizers. However, I hated their shaving cream to the point where I returned it, and I very rarely return things. So I would just steer clear of that one, I mean, unless you already use it and it works for you. I do like the Jack Black Supreme Cream. This is a triple cushion shave lather with macadamia nut oil and soy. So if you want something easier than a soap, you could use this. You can put a dab on your shaving brush and apply it that way, or you can just apply it with your hands, however you prefer. But definitely a great product. You want to stay away from the aerosols. They tend to be actually more drying, and the whole point of a shaving cream is to keep your face hydrated, to make for a smoother experience. So the standard foam cans. Anyway, there are tons of videos and there's a lot of information on the web about that. So, So even with the straight razor, I was only able to shave every couple days. But I got the advantage that it was cheaper than shaving with a modern system, the Fusion, Mach 3, etc. Those blades are outrageously expensive, and I needed a new one for every shave, or else my skin would break out something terrible, and I would not get a good shave. I had to figure something else out. So now, my father has been using an electric shaver for my whole life. Let's see, he's 92 now. For I'm 27, almost 28. So he's been using it as long as I can remember, and probably even before that. And he uses a Braun foil razor. Whenever I used his razor, especially when I first started shaving, wanting to be like Dad, I would break out terribly, I would not get a smooth shave at all. And he shaves for, I'd say, a good 45 minutes in the morning, pulling his, you know, making sure everything's tight, and, like, he's kind of like me in that he needs, like, a perfectly smooth shave, or else it irritates him throughout the day. So I avoided electric shavers for a long time. Well, I had a credit on Amazon, and it was kind of frustrating to me that I couldn't shave every day and maintain a smooth shave. So I figured I might as well see if the technology's improved, and I had never tried one of the rotary shavers. So typical me, I went all the way to the extreme, which is a Philips Norelco SensiTouch 3D model number 1280XCC, which has a really neat cleaning lubricating system that's in the bathroom. So can't show you that, but I brought the razor out. It's got tons of features. Honestly, I was a little bit overwhelmed by the owner's manual at first, but I was not expecting the quality shave that I got and the lack of the irritation that I've got. And they say it takes about 2 weeks to get used to it. The first day, a little bit of redness on my neck. I guess I was pressing too hard. But today I used it and it was amazing. So this is what I currently use, and it kind of goes against my principles of sticking traditional, but you know what? I get a great shave with it. The one annoyance is getting close to my sideburns because it's a triple head. It's a little bit difficult to get a good shave, but I in that area, so I pull and stretch my skin with my free hand and shave as best as I can, and it's getting better and better, and I'm sure I'll figure out the technique. And there's also a little trimmer that pulls out on the other side. Really easy to clean. It's got a great electric unit that self-cleans. I usually rinse the heads out and then put it in, but I spoke with Phillips and you do not have to. Another thing, I'm of ethnic descent, let's just leave it at that. So, kind of, the good thing is that I don't burn in the summer. The bad thing is that I have had body hair to a point of excess. And I tried laser hair removal, spent probably $10,000 total. Between back, chest, just to remove some, did not work. And my friends and I often joke that it should come with a warning label or a precaution. This method not designed for Greeks or Italians. So I got this, which is the Body Groom Pro. This is also Philips Norelco, and it has a foil cutter here with some open comb cutters to catch the longer hairs, and then the foil cutter to catch the smaller hairs. It's long enough that if you have back hair, you can reach and do some kind of acrobatic maneuvers. It actually helps me stretch before a workout. It's a great tool, and then because it's the Pro, it's got a built-in trimmer with actually five different heights. So if you do your own haircuts, if you want to trim your sideburns, you can do that with this. And this does not have a cleaning system, but it's really easy to just pop off the head, and comes with a cleaning brush, and it has a charging stand. So great product. Now let's talk about after the shave. Something that a lot of you probably haven't seen. This is called an alum block, and it lasts a long, long time. I've had this one for probably 3 years, and not much of it, if at all, has worn down. And if you know, a lot aluminum is in like underarm deodorants, etc. It has antibacterial properties. Well, this is like an alum block, and basically it has this nice little case. This particular one is by ShaveX. I got this on classicshaving.com. It's the unscented, natural antiseptic, non-staining, Leaves no residue on skin upon application. And yeah, it lasts a long, long time. What you do, after you finish shaving, you wet this bar and just rub it across your face. It stings a little bit, I will warn you, but definitely helps with the redness, splotchiness, ingrown hairs, etc. Now, if you remember from earlier in my video, I said that I really like some of the TrueFit and Hill products. Well, this is their aftershave balm. Excuse me. The particular scent is the Trafalgar, which I purchased because I used to use the Trafalgar cologne as well, so I wasn't competing scents. But the Trafalgar cologne, and cologne really, you should just spray enough for people who are like in an intimate distance to get like a light smell. Just for that required about 3 sprays behind each ear. And so I would go through a bottle of this, and it's not cheap, relatively quickly. But the Trafalgar aftershave balm, and they have a few scents depending on what you like, is a great lotion, does not burn. So after I use the Allen Block, I just use that, it's like a little facial moisturizer too, and really great. The next thing, back to razors. Okay, some of you are going to find this odd, but if you're set on wet shaving and you don't like the Mach 3 Fusions or whatever, don't work for you, and you're weary of a straight razor, of a safety razor for some reason, this was actually a friend of mine called me up one day and told me that he just got a great shave. He was over his girlfriend's house, had forgotten his razor, and used her this is a Gillette Venus and Olay woman's razor designed for shaving legs. It's got a moisturizing bar built in. It's got your soap, etc., your shaving soap. So you just rinse this and shave. And if it wasn't for the cost of the cartridges, like the other wet razor blades, I can only really use this once. Maybe twice. And these cartridges are kind of pricey, so if it wasn't for that, I'd probably honestly stick with that. Although there is a small problem. I'm very sensitive. Here, there's always these little hairs, and like right under my chin, that are very difficult to get. Usually require multiple passes. Very irritated. I used to get very irritated. And still that there would be hairs left. Other trouble spots right here, used all the techniques from the straight razor place forums, from watching YouTube videos on shaving technique. So anyway, okay, back on track. All right, so now we've covered pre-shaving, shaving, colognes. I showed you what I used to use. What I currently use now is the Florist number 89. Amazing. Just one spray behind each ear. I can smell it. It's amazing. It's just a great, clean smell. It was Ian Fleming, the author of the James Bond books. It was his personal favorite. It's mentioned in a lot of the James Bond books. And it's a great cologne. So I'm not saying it's cheap, but I can imagine that bottle's going to last a while. This is my first bottle, and I just got it last week. So that's what I use now. Okay, so that's cologne. Next thing, hair. I work out 6 days a week, and I kind of have a phobia of hair care products running down my face. I feel like they blocked my pores, caused me to break out. So I used to, when I used the Kiehl's products, and a couple of the gels, mousses, things like that that I've tried in the past, they would just run down my face and I would feel gross until I was able to take a shower. Well, I found the new barbershop that I've been going to. It's called the Belmont Barbershop in Chicago. It's unbelievable. And I saw this product there. It's called Layrite. It's a deluxe pomade. It says, holds like a wax, washes out like a gel. This is an amazing, amazing product. Smells great. It's like an orange gel. You don't have to use that much, maybe like a dime-sized amount. And you know what? I just got done a 3-hour workout, and look at my hair. So, but does not run down, and they actually have a stronger hold version. So you can get this online. I bought this one at a local men's high-end clothing store called Haberdash, which I highly recommend if you're in the Chicago area or you will be visiting. It's definitely worth a stop. And then, so I just take a little bit of that, rub it in between my hands, and just go straight back, trying not to get it on the scalp. That's kind of that leads to blocked pores and increased hair loss, something I cannot afford. So then comb. I got this on Classic Shaving a while ago. It's, I believe this is antelope bone, made in France. This is great. Love it. Keep it in the pouch. Just a really classy experience. So really enjoy that. And that's about it. I mean, underarm deodorants are personal preference. Just please do the world a favor and stay away from Axe. Women don't like it. Maybe if you're 12. Other than that, not really great. So the sh this one last thing, shaving brush. When you're finished using it, rinse it out well, and then get yourself a shaving brush stand. And you always want it to dry with the bristles down. That'll maintain the shape of it. I take this, rinse out my shaving bowl, and put it back in. Now with the shaver I was showing you, which again is the Philips Noralco SensorTouch 3D, so it's got the pivoting heads that follow the contours great. I got the 1280 XCC, which has the cleaning system, the jet clean system, which is just fun to even watch. It raises and lowers the shaver. I guess I should start getting used to calling it shaver, into the cleaning solution that's refillable. And you only really have to replace the head once every year, it says. So, and that's what I've heard from reviews. So even if you have to, it's, I think, maybe $25. Don't quote me on that, I haven't even looked, but I'm sure you can find it on eBay, Amazon, etc. I got 10 bottles of the solution, which lasts me quite some time. Anyway, so if any of you notice an audio comparison between this video and my other ones, I decided to try out. I just got this Go Mic by Samson portable USB microphone for recording, and that's what I'm currently using on my MacBook Pro. It'll work with a Mac. It comes with some sort of a recording software that is for PC. Kind of unfair to us Mac users, so take note, Samson. But no, there's great apps on Mac for recording that are compatible with it. But I bought this for recording lectures, and I just wanted to see how it worked for this compared to my Blue Yeti that I usually use. So that's about it. If you have any grooming questions, want me to go further in depth on anything, feel free to post a comment. I'd really like to see some more comments up, good and bad. It's a learning experience. So thank you for watching, and BGA signing off. Thanks. Either. Furthermore, even just one shave, the blade, the next time I shaved, would just slice up my skin. And I researched technique, etc. Didn't apply too much pressure. One thing I'll say that I did do, I cannot stand the feeling of any hair left on my face after I shave. You know, if I miss a spot, some people don't care. The official men's stylist rule of thumb is don't shave against the grain. If I don't shave against the grain all day long, I'm doing this. And if... Hello, YouTube. This is BGA. Hope everyone's doing well. It's kind of a cloudy, rainy day here, so I figured I'd do a couple videos. And the first one I want to do is talking to you about some of the grooming products that I use. Primarily shaving, but I'll get into some other things as well. On the topic of shaving, I have a very sensitive skin and a relatively coarse beard. Not a great combination. Furthermore, my hair grows in a million different directions. So if I'm wearing a sweater, let's say, it's going to irritate my neck. So I had to shave against the grain, and I was only happy with when I shaved against the grain. So it would take a while to shave. Could really only shave in the shower without slicing up my face. Always used high quality products, but it took a lot of trial and error. As I got older and more into the professional world, I realized that I had two choices: either grow a beard or figure something out. So I researched shaving for my skin type. And if anybody's just getting into sort of luxury shaving or more comfortable shaving than your drugstore products will provide, the chances are you'll stumble across a company called The Art of Shaving. I'm not going to say anything bad about them, but it's kind of like buying your car cleaning supplies from your car dealership. You're paying a premium for products that aren't necessarily better. For example, this is the Art of Shaving pre-shave oil. So shaving for me has not always been the most pleasant or comfortable experience. The pattern I was in was I would when I could say the first real razor I remember using was the Gillette Mach 3 when it had first come out, and I would only be able to use it maybe once every 3 days. If I shaved consecutive days, I would get terrible skin irritation, redness, especially my neck, and it wouldn't be a smooth shave.